on in terms of one of the biggest challenges for global health and national health is the commercial determinants of health. As we speak, the new Director General of the World Health Organization, who has just opened the UN meeting on non-communicable diseases in Uruguay, one of the first things that he's said is that we must tackle the commercial determinants of health. That's one of the first times that the Director General has said that very publicly at a UN meeting like that. So there's a moment of opportunity, I think, within that system to really take on the issues that you spoke about. But, so my apologies, sir, I don't know the situation within the Philippines as it relates to the WHO code around marketing of breast milk substitutes to children. But what we see is this issue of, so you've got things like the WHO code around that issue, which is a soft power, it's a soft regulatory instrument, sitting alongside some of the trade and investment treaties, which are hard, legally binding instruments. And what I was trying to make the point was, unless we recognise the power of such instruments like that, so the investment mechanisms through some of those treaties will always trump the health, the WHO codes or the WHO guidelines. There are ways, of course, to overcome structural power. But it means for us in health, in the health space, we need to be at the table when it comes to the trade and investment discussions. So I understand here in the Philippines, you have a tobacco company now about to invest in the country. From a health perspective, why on earth is that happening? From an economic perspective, colleagues will tell me otherwise, but from a health perspective, that's a disaster. Now, it also then means that you've got a tobacco company protected by the investment provisions within the trade and investment treaties who will now be able to potentially sue the Philippines government if you want to bring in health policy measures to address some of the concerns for tobacco. That's a commercial interest. One of the other things I would say about it is we have almost no uniform approach to conflicts of interest. And again, there's a big, big piece of work that's going on, being led by the World Health Organization through FENSA, which is the framework for engagement with non-state actors, including commercial interests, to think about conflicts of interest and how you might manage them, particularly from a Ministry of Health perspective. So incredibly challenging space. I'd love to hear more from colleagues about how you do that within the Philippines context.